Charlie.
Hey, Ritchie, darling, how are you?
I'm really missing you, Charlie. I'm looking
forward to seeing you.
Yeah, me too, bruv.
Good. Well, go home and don't miss your plane.
Over my dead body.
Probably one for you to start.
Well, actually, bizarrely and unusually, came from the distributor, Anchor Bay, and the two guys there, Rod and Colin, had come up with this concept that they wanted to make a kind of urban revenge movie about old criminals from the craze era coming out onto the street and kind of cleaning it up with this new era of hoodie young guys. And they wanted to call it We Still Kill the Old Way. And they said to me, this is what we want you to do, go away and make it. And they were thankfully very, very kind of accommodating. And Sasha and I had been looking to do something together for a number of years, and we kind of had a few first dates and not got past first base in terms of making movies. And this one, we kind of got to third and married and, cinematically.
And yeah, and we're going for fourth on the next
movie.
Yeah, and for me, I just thought it was a really lovely concept that it's different to another British gangster movie in so much that it's old boys coming out of retirement who don't do things. You know, the way that we have seen in the last 10 years of gangster, British gangster movies, anyway, and there was a certain class about them, and I thought, well, that's really interesting. That sort of becomes something not original because it's a revenge movie, but certainly on the way to becoming something that is its own thing rather than just a photocopy of something that's happened before. Well, yeah,
we had a lot of fun, didn't we?
Yes,
there was a lot of actors of a certain vintage in this movie who we both loved as kids, and the best thing about this job was kind of going into the toy box of all the movies you loved as a kid and taking out the best toys and getting to play with them, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And you know, we had Alison Doody from Indiana Jones, Lizette Anthony from Kral, Ian Ogilvy who was a saint, Chris Ellison who was Burnside. I mean, every single person was a pleasure, weren't they?
Yeah, exactly.
And then we also got to cast some really, really amazing young actors, all of whom kind of came to us quite organically. Danny Boy Hatchard, who we think is giving a real breakout performance in the movie. He was recommended to me by Danny Dyer. Danny Dyer's daughter is in the movie, and she's fantastic.
A lot of the E2 gang as well, sort of the secondary characters, as it were. Everyone rose to... Some of them only got three lines, but boy, do you remember them. And Red Madrell.
Red Madrell, who's the very pretty girl member of the gang, her character was a boy. And we both had this kind of inspirational moment of, why don't we make one of them a girl?
Yeah.
I think it's probably more your idea than mine.
I'd had the idea, but he said it first.
And,
that's genuine. I was sat there thinking, he's going to think I'm nuts if I say this, so I'll keep quiet.
But then Sasha said, in an ideal world, who would you have? And I said Red Madrell, and we got her, and we were so lucky, and she's so brilliant in the movie.
Yeah, yeah. Pretty much every day was a blast, wasn't it?
It was the most fun I've ever had on a movie. It was, every day was a pleasure, wasn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Even that day you were crying in the corner, saying you were never going to work in a movie again.
That was when he said, we might fold. But I think...
Never fold, just wave.
Yeah, pause, maybe. I think maybe Spain was a lot
Spain
of fun
great,
because
it?
It's not just you say rap and everyone goes home. It was rap and then everyone goes out and drinks angrier. And so that was a lot of fun. And listening to Ian and Nicky Henson came out, who's the cop in the movie.
Those two together were just brilliant, weren't they?
They were like, the two old boys in the Muppets sat in the... They were like them.
It really was.
In a very nice way, I mean that. And they'd regale tales. And after about 3 hours, you know, everyone's like, tell us another story in that kind of sarcastic way. But they go, oh, okay then, remember?
As we were taking off in the plane, the tannoy announcement comes on. And Ogilvy looks over at the town and he goes, don't they know I'm mid-anecdote? He was just brilliant. He's such a legend.
Yeah, so, you know, the whole shoot was really lovely. I don't think we really had a day where it started hitting the fan. It was always...
And it was the happiest experience I've had working with the director. I have to say, it was a pleasure. Every day having you on the phone.
It was the happiest experience I've worked with. No,
it is.
Well,
we've got a couple of things cooking away. We're hoping we're going to make a sequel to this. We've got a very strong concept for it, which Sasha's come up with, called We Still Steal the Old Way.
More Ocean's 11-y, so less bleakness. And then I've written something for the BBC, and you're making a movie next month.
Yeah.
But we've got a couple of projects together anyway.
Got a couple
anyway.
Of things simmering. But we had such a great time making this movie. If we could make six of these, we would, because they were just great, weren't they?
Yeah.
So please, everyone, go out and buy it, because then we can make another one.
Yes, please. Living, breathing.
Yeah, they're always good.
Food and water, I'm a massive fan of.
Water, wine.
And wine as well. I love movies. That's kind of always been my life outside of family. But, you know, I've lived and breathed movies for so long now. I've been, although I'm quite young to look at, I'm older than him. I've been in the business for 27 years now. So it's all about movies for me.
Yeah, me too. And, you know, one of the things that we bond over is love of, like, you know, movies. Unusual movies sometimes. Both love this movie that Liz Anthony was in called Without a Clue, which she'd rather forget. So ask her about that one.
It's fantastic.
It's a brilliant movie.
It's hilarious. And it's Michael Caine and Ben Kingsley. So.
As Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson. What more could you want?
Yeah.
Now
yeah,
we're like the 12 men of the Muppets.
No, tell us about... There are some names, but if we mention them, they'll probably push their price up. So.
Or die. That's what yeah.
The curse of the old way.
Yeah. When we were making this, every time we were like, let's get Edward Woodward, he's dead. Let's get Lewis Collins, he's dead. I mean, it was quite a depressing casting, wasn't it?
Yeah. There was one guy that we actively went after, but then he didn't have a UK agent, which basically meant it wasn't going to work out.
But
in the sequels, we'd love to be bringing in more and more of these guys, and it becomes a kind of... Hopefully not a revolving door thing because someone's died, but the gang...
The gang will expand, hopefully.
Yeah, because the concept is that obviously they used to be like a craze-like gang, so there can be a never-ending cast list. So, yeah. But, you know, we'll see how it pans out.
We might have to cut the budget, in which case it'll just be one.
Those are no claims bonus. Go for this lock.